I wanted to be a part of The Best of Me, mostly because I'd never done a love story before. It's a genre that I hadn't had the opportunity to be a part of, and it's very timeless. And I guess you could say I'm a bit of a romantic. And I just fell in love with the story, and I'm very excited about being a part of it and with the particular cast I am a part of it with. The Best of Me is about two people, Amanda Reynolds and Dawson Cole, and it's really about the two of them being reunited after 20 years apart. They come back to this town where they started their relationship. They were high school sweethearts who were madly in love, and they come back to town for a mutual friend's funeral. And in that particular time, they unexpectedly see each other, and their love is reignited. However, they're adults now, so there's a little bit more baggage, and it's really essentially about their conflict. I play Amanda Reynolds. She's a married woman, she's a mother of two, and seemingly from the outside, she looks like she probably has the perfect life. But what we come to find out soon enough is that she's very lonely, and she's lost herself somewhat in this marriage. The marriage has been filled with some tragedy, and there's some issues, and she's longing for something else. I think when she's confronted with Dawson and their history, and their shared past, it becomes a very difficult decision for her. There's a part of her that is renewed, a sense of herself, of finding herself again, and that passion, and yet realizing she's established a life elsewhere. She's taken a different path, and she doesn't know how to rectify that. She feels very, very much torn and conflicted as to what is the best thing to do. I think that's one of the most beautiful themes of the film people can relate to. I think we always sort of question ourselves as adults, and we look back at our past and we sort of say, well, what if I would have taken that path? What if I would have gone down that road? What in my life would be different? And I think that's just sort of a natural thing to do. And that's certainly what we see here in this film. And in fact, there's a second chance. And what are you going to do with that second chance? And that's intriguing. The older version of Dawson is played by James Marsden, or Jimmy, as I like to call him. He is so wonderful. I think what makes Jimmy so right for this role is, well, he's so easy on the eyes. Let's first like put that out in the open. But he has this real inherent goodness about him. He's just got these incredible qualities. He's so kind, and he's such a gentleman. And he really evokes the spirit, I think, of the Nicholas Sparks leading men. And I just enjoy every day working with him so much. He's just such an awesome guy, and he's just a beautiful actor. Liana Liberato plays the younger version of me, and I so admire this, the essence of her, of how she's really established Amanda, essentially. She's this vivacious girl who is taken the world by the storm. She's has this very idealistic point of view on the world, and I love what she does with the character, because it really allows myself to then take that journey, and you see how the years have worn on Amanda due to the things that she's experienced. And so she loses some of that vivaciousness, I guess you could say, in her older years. And then when her you know, when she's brought back together with Dawson, I'm able to sort of infuse that again, once again. And so it's a nice little arc for me that she's created. It's going to tug on your heartstrings, of course. I mean, when you think of Nicholas Sparks, you think of love predominantly, and loss and tragedy and hope and perseverance and all of these things. And if you are a romantic at heart, you will not be disappointed. You know, it's a great date film for sure. And it's just a really, it's a lovely film.